students, myself, Nirmal Singh, Department of Mathematics, Art Science Council. Today, as we know that we are studying about Nita and Nita Yamakuchen, in which we studied about the definition of Nita Yamakuchen.
Yes, equals to we have to x raised to x equals to y square. To find dx, we differentiate x with respect to x, we get dx equals to 2y dy. As in integration, x running from 0 to infinity, y also running from 0 to infinity, we will get gamma of 1 by 2 is equal to negative 1 0 to infinity e raised to minus y square into y square raised to 1 minus 1 by 2 into 2y dy. We will get gamma of 1 by 2 0 to infinity, taking to outside, we will get 2 0 to infinity e raised to minus y square, 2 and get cancelled, we get y raised to minus 1 into y dy. Gamma of 1 by 2 equals to 2 into 0 to infinity e raised to minus y square, y minus 1 plus 1 dy. Since we know that a is equal to n into a is equal to n plus 2, a is equal to n plus, then 2 integration from 0 to infinity e raised to minus y square, it becomes y minus 1 plus 1 equals to y raised to 0, which is 1. So we will get directly gamma of 1 by 2 is equal to 2 integration from 0 to infinity e raised to minus y square dy. What we have done to prove this, we have used the actual definition of gamma function, which is gamma of n is equal to integration from 0 to infinity e raised to minus x, x raised to n minus 1 dx. Then we replace n by 1 by 2 in the equation A, and we will get gamma of 1 by 2 is equal to integration from 0 to infinity e raised to minus x, x raised to 1 by 2 minus dx. And after replacing n equal to 1 by 2, we will get integration from 0 to infinity e raised to minus x, x raised to minus 1 by 2 dx. Now put x equals to y square, we will get dx equals to 2y dy, because we have to change or we have to replace x by y square. So we have to replace dx in the form of dy. We will get dx equals to 2y dy as x runs from 0 to infinity. If we put x equals to 0, then we will get y square equals to 0 is y equals to 0. And when we put x equals to infinity, y square, so y equals to infinity. So as x runs from 0 to infinity, y runs from 0 to infinity. Now we have put these values of x and y in this equation. So we need x replaced by y square. So we get e raised to minus y square into again x, y square raised to minus 1 by 2 as it is, dx equals to 2y dy. So minus y raised to y square raised to minus 1 by 2, 2 and 1 by 2 get cancelled, you get y raised to minus 1 into y dy. 2 as a constant, we take it out from the integration and we get 2 into integration from 0 to infinity e raised to minus y into y raised to minus 1 plus 1 dy, and minus 1 plus 1 we will get equals to 0, is y equals to 0 is equals to 1, and we get gamma of 1 by 2 equals to 2 into integration from 0 to infinity e raised to minus y square t bar. Similarly, if we write this equation in x form, we will get gamma of 1 by 2 into integration from 0 to infinity e raised to minus x square dx. We have just replaced y by x. We will get this type of equation. Now, consider x is equal to r cos theta and y is equal to r sin theta. Correct? Or we can say that if we multiply equation this one, 1 and 2, multiply by equation 1 and 2, we will get gamma of 1 by 2 into gamma of 1 by 2, 2 integration from 0 to infinity, e raised to minus y square dy into 2 integration from 0 to infinity, e raised to minus x square dy. Correct. We can write gamma of 1 by 2 second square is equal to 2 to the 4 integration from 0 to infinity integration from 0 to infinity e raised to minus x square into e raised to minus 5 square dx and this is our required equation. Now, if you make this and try to solve, what we will get? We will get on the 0 to infinity, 0 to infinity, e raised to minus x square, e raised to minus y square, e raised to minus x square. If we solve this integration from 0 to infinity, 0 to infinity, minus x outside, we get x square plus y square dx and dy. Correct? Now, replace x by r cos theta and y with r sin theta. And dx, dy, we will get r. With Jacobian, with the help of Jacobian theorem, we will get dx dy equals to r dr theta. Now, finding limits of integration, you know that integration of limits of x and y is given as starting from 0, x running from 0 to infinity, and y is same 0 to infinity. But when we put x equals to 0, x equals to 0, then we will get 0 into r cos theta. Cos theta is equal to 0. And we will get cos theta is equal to 0 and theta is equal to 5 by 2. Correct? So now theta is going from 0 to 5 by 2. And for y is equal to 0, we will take 0 r sin theta. And if theta is equal to 0, means theta is equal to 0, and when infinity, y is equal to infinity r sin theta, but theta is a bounded function, in between 2 by. So our radius is 1. So r becomes 2 3. So radius is infinity, but the theta is only up to pi by 2. So we can write this equation such as integration from 0 to pi by 2, integration from 0 to infinity, e is to x square plus y square. R square sin square theta. Taking out R square outside, we get cos square theta plus sin square theta. We will do 1, we will get R square only. So we can write it as R square R dr theta. Correct? Now, we will try to solve this equation. Put p equals to r square. So we get dp equals to 2r dr. And we can put here 0 to pi by 2 as r running from 0 to infinity, also running from 0 to infinity, e is to minus p because r square is to p, and r dr is equal to dp by 2, and we are adding as it is. Now integration of e is to minus p. Here we get 1 by 2 taking outside, integration of 0 to pi by 2, integration of e raised to minus p, integration of e raised to minus p minus 1, and the limits of the integration will be infinity to t. Correct? Now, putting the values of integration, we will take we have used Jacobian theorem to find dx dy, and we have used we convert Cartesian coordinate into polar coordinate with the help of these two important substitution and application. We deduce that we have now 1 by 2 is equal to root pi. Similarly, we can now we will study some forms of beta and gamma. Some forms of different forms of beta and gamma. Different type of forms, such as take one gamma of n is equal to gamma of n is equal to linear from 0 to infinity or 0 to 1. Gamma of n is equal to integration of 0 to 1 log of y log of 1 of y raised to n minus 1 divided. We have to prove gamma of n is equal to integration from 0 to 1 log of 1 upon y raised to n minus 1 divided. Since we know that gamma of n is equal to the integral from 0 to infinity e raised to minus x, x raised to n minus 1, correct? So put log of 1 upon y is equal to x. Log of 1 upon y is equal to x. We can write this as log of y equals to minus 1 equals to x, or we can write it as log of y equals to x, or log of y equals to minus x, and we can write it y equals to minus x. Now we have find the value of y is equal to x, y is equal to e raised to minus x. With the help of this, we can write minus 1 upon y dy equals to e x. Correct? Now put this value in the equation. Since as x will be from 0 to infinity, y will run from, with the help of this equation, y will run from 0 to 1, e raised to minus x is equal to y, x raised to n minus 1, x is log of 1 upon y raised to n minus 1, and dx is equal to minus 1 upon y dy. As x runs from 0 to infinity, y runs from 1 to 0, then we will get y will cancel minus 1, 1 to 0, log of 1 upon y raised to n minus 1 dy. So we can write it as 0 to 1 log of 1 upon y raised to x to n minus 1 into y. This is equal to gamma of n. So it is a different form of gamma in the form of logarithmic value. In this form, when we solve some quantity value problem, we come across logarithmic function, and which is not easily solvable. So to make it easy to solve, we convert gamma of n into logarithmic form. And with the help of this formula or this form, we can solve the example very easily. So remember the another form of gamma n in logarithmic form, and it needs to be remembered in this paper, the form of gamma n in the logarithmic form. In the next lecture, we will try to find some more different kinds of forms of beta and gamma function to solve boundary value problems in easy manner. Till then, thank you.